I shall take care of them.
Interfering.
We won't lose.
Grant me strength.
Feel this fear.
Attacking.
This is for all of our sakes.
Well?
Thank you.
not afraid.
Here I go. Right.
Here I go. Better take this seriously.
Back me up.
So strong now.
You stay put.
I got this.
Damn it! be afraid.
Your numbers don't mean squat.
Best I can do, but...
Time for some pain!
Easy now.
Ready yourselves.
Serves you right.
Take a little break, why don't you?
Time for some pain!
So strong now.
Not good.
I got this.
about grit.
Don't be afraid. Take a little break, why don't you?
Need some fighting spirit!
This is the best I can do, but...
It's all about grit.
You stay put.
Thank you. prepared to beg for your life.
Yomiyasui!
That didn't hurt.
Feel this pain.
The goat girl's bindings garner cold stares as she walks through town, but she does not care. For no matter what terrible things might happen, she has the companionship of a very kind monster. Yet another day finds her racing down the street for the ruin where the monster waits. Suddenly, she comes to a halt. Smoke tickles her nostrils. Her face clouds. Something is on fire. Knowing this bodes ill, she makes for the ruin as fast as she... I hope Mr. Monster is okay, she thinks to herself. She soon arrives at the ruin. It is ablaze. Flames billow from a great pile of discarded junk. Broken chairs. Shattered clocks. The flames lick at the flowers, threatening to turn... The ruin was meant to be a secret place for herself and the monster. And now it is lost. Mr. Monster, no. She sounds as though she could start sobbing at any moment. The monster is sitting listlessly in the middle of the ruin. He's going to die. But as she leaps into the... She's here. The goat is here. High-pitched laughter scratches the girl's ears. She turns in the direction of the voice. The four girls from the plaza are waiting for her. Their leader takes a step forward, a lopsided smile on her face. In her hand, she holds a stick, the tips smoldering with flame. She realizes these four are the ones who set the ruin to burn. The ones who stole her special place. A black snake worms its way into her heart. She has never felt such an emotion before. "You're awful," she mutters fiercely. "How dare you do this to Mr. Monster?" Mr. Monster? The children exchange glances and begin to snicker amongst themselves. A moment later, the leader speaks. "Your Mr. Monster doesn't exist, goat. He's just a thing from a picture book." The leader had glimpsed the girl's secret. She saw her playing by herself. She saw her speak to empty air. "You poor thing. You must have been so lonely." Her words tear at the goat girl like glass. "Don't you get it? You made the monster up." The girl remains quiet, but then... "No, he's here. I know he's here." She refuses to acknowledge it. She cannot. Doing so would mean her only friend does not exist. "Are you okay, Mr. Monster? You must be in so much pain." With teetering steps, she enters the flames. She finds herself entering an empty space. Flames lick at her legs, her arms. But she pays them no because she can see. She sees the monster sitting amidst the fire, his body covered in burns. He is her precious friend. Her hand brushes Empa to her. It is the monster's cheek. She crouches down to pluck a single burning flower at the monster's feet. Hot fire chars her palm. The pain is an idle thing. Distant. For this is all their fault. Her gaze rests, dancing flames reflect in dull eyes.